One hand. Dum 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 dum. My first girlfriend lived right down here. This is a really serious drive for me. Is that a cop? No. Because this was like right at the last minute, like before I get to her house, when I'd like do like some final like, you know, like grab a piece of gum. Just in case, you know, if I was pulling up and she was watching, she didn't like see me do that shit when I got to her house. There's this vibration in Chinatown that I wrote so much of it in cars. To be in cars, driving, imagining like my world whipping by me while I was just singing. I mean, get in my backseat, honey pie, it's a car song.
I love these tuners and I'm so aesthetically offended by them at the same time. It's a folk move and I would play it in C usually. And they've used it a lot, like a song like Better Love, an old Steel Train song, it has that movement. It's kind of like, it makes you want to like, kind of pick fast. It's a way of, you know, pedaling on a note and kind of hunched over my guitar. And I did that voice, but really slow. And sometimes when I'm writing, I'm like real low. And in my backseat, honey pie. Almost like I'm talking to myself. And I was like, that's what they said, and it's like, it's mine. And I just remember like playing around with this and being like, it's nice. And then, a girl like you, bring me out of my head. And then the part that I thought was really good, is I said, black tears on your cheek, I want them in my bed, I'll take you out of the city. That's what I was like, shit, take the sadness out of Saturday night, wear your sadness like it's mine, black tears, I want them in my bed. Almost like the hallmarks of the song and the whole album is that like, yeah, we could write all these romantic songs about all these things we want, but what if the deepest expression of it is like, yeah, I'll take your sadness. I'll take it. Black tears in my bed, I want them there. So it started like, thought it was gonna be a really sad song. It started like this. And I wrote it, quickly, and I just recorded this. Wake up, I'm not alright, it's kind of trash, but I think I said Jesus, take the sadness out of Saturday night. Probably because I was thinking about Jesus and Mary Chain when I was writing this. So this is all fumbly, but the chorus I had. And this chorus was done, except sitting on the front stoop, crying because they're crazy. That was like the one line where I was like, and then I got crying out the crazy, which is like so much better. And sometimes it's like that tiny thing, like crying because they're crazy versus crying out the crazy. And I didn't get Bruce saying crying out the crazy. So I only got, so I had to fill him in after that. Crying out the crazy, I'll take you. Comes back. So there's just one little moment where you lose Bruce for a second because I changed the lyric. And I didn't want to like go back and do it. I was like, this is great. We had this really crazy moment where it was played in the song, we drifted in the studio, me, him, and Patty were all messing with it, he's singing on it, and then I didn't want to go back and do it. It was such an amazing moment. And the idea also of having Bruce on something is like, could have really only happened organically. He's such an important person in my life, an inspiration of my work. The first person, artist that I heard that made me feel like the place I am from had a sound, had value. There's a perspective to write from. Through New Jersey, which is a huge part of this album. But it was just this brooding thing, which is, I was like, cool. And then I was messing around, and this is like the big shift point. Started playing this thing. Let me show you how I did it. Hey, John? Whatever. What's guitar, 14? John? Like this kind of stuff. I didn't have the line yet, which would eventually be, fuck, hold on. So I'm messing around with just like noise. And what I got was this. As soon as I hear that low end, I just like hear myself. It's so sad, but so heavy at the same time. All right, so there's those basic elements. Now I'm starting to drift away from the demo version. And I go right out there. That was one track. And this was another track. Never changes. But a girl like you. The only changes. Yeah, I wanna find tomorrow with you, baby. This builds up. And every bit of rhythm comes from the tape delay. Which is really cool because the song is so rhythmic, but it's not the drummer playing it. It's the delay. Which is nice because since it's analog and since it's tape, you can't set it, so it's the delays are not perfectly in time. Which is why the song has a feeling to it that I could fuck with but can't really recreate. There. It's really high energy. And that's when like the idea of the song of being this like big dense world where it just starts and you're in this. Such a far cry from the demo, which was so like. And it builds and it builds and it builds, but. I just wanted to like live in that immediately. And then living behind all that, which makes it feel so romantic and delicate is. So basically, the song is almost like layers of like huge toughness, the low end and the distortion, the drums. The song is so brooding romantic, I thought it would start, you know, get in my backseat, honey pie. I never thought it would start. Ooh, yeah! But I was holding the mic and I was like, oh, this is sick. Oh, it's about to come in. Started singing along with Evan's part. Evan Smith, who plays saxophone in Bleachers. And he did this. He goes. And I was like, whoa! I didn't write that part. He did, and it's a game-changing part. And then Patrick starts playing the bells. And they're moving, but they're following the line. And then it leaves so much space for the vocal. And that's when I was like, fuck, like that's the feeling, like, now you're really, it's not a folk song anymore, you're holding the lyric. But you're also like, what happened to those parts I love? And they fill out the chorus so good. It almost makes me feel like when Evan wrote that line and played it, I felt like, oh, it's the musical embodiment of what I'm talking about. This hope, a girl like you, buh, 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 take you into the shadow. It's like, sounds like an instrument's having the feeling of what you're saying, which is the coolest moment when you can hear that. And then you go back to the demo without those things. It's just like someone like talking in a mirror with no like magic. Even when it came to Bruce's vocal, because I would play it back and I would think, well, Bruce sounds so cool, just acoustic. But at the same time, I remember thinking, well, I kind of heard him like that before. I needed some shit I never heard before. Some weird magics, you know? Some strings happening. Fucked up drums. Here's Springsteen. And you put all that together, and obviously I'm just recreating it now, but like, then it was like, I got all these fucked up things, let's fucking control them, and like bring them into a zone where the whole song, I saw it like this, is like vibrating.
You know, the way the strings and the whole tension is this like.
It's a It's a harpsichord and a thing called an emulator, which is this weird 80s synth that takes floppy disks. And literally on the screen it says, this will take a long time every time you go between sounds. It's absurd. Death of creativity, but really cool. I bounced them together, and there's different voices happening in different places. So I remember one key was going, and then one key was going, ding, ding, ding. It was a harpsichord sound. So I only have it together. This is one track. It's like a million instruments, but it's just me playing one thing. One hand. So I thought to myself, oh, that hyperstring could be such a amazing, you know, quartet moment. And I brought them in, and we did it. It just kind of happens for a second, but then when we're in there, I was like, you know what, let's make a beautiful arrangement, let's play all this stuff. That's also, you know, and that's the line between being alone, you know, this is me alone fucking with a synthesizer. It's fucked up. These are players who know what they're doing. But you put them together. And this thing happens, which I love in my music, where you hear me wrestling and working it out and kind of in my room, and then you hear me dreaming of what it could be, but then you hear it.
Give me that strange red light. Big red light.
And we did this expensive moment that only at the very end of Chinatown. We're past the running down the long way part, we're passing the I wanna run part, we're just sort of screaming at each other. And as it's fading, you get this huge, and that kills me. And they're all sort of hanging sort of like right off the relief note. So it really sounds like that uncertainty falling in love. You're dangling with it, but you'd never hear it. You'd miss it if it was gone, but you'd never know it. You know, you at that point in the song, you're so like, you're so, your head's just in this zone. And you've had the emotion of everything I've been yelping about, and Bruce joining me, and
the crescendo, I wanna find tomorrow with you,
when everything's alive, and you just never know that there's these like wilting flowers dying in the background. And sometimes I wonder with moments like that, if you would miss it, or if it's just for me, I don't know. But when I hear the song, I think that it's so tough, and it's like, this like big tough expression of falling in love, like a big leap of faith or something. And maybe this is like the tiny voice in the back of your head that's like, what if you hurt me?